tell me. I take it much unkindly that thou, Iago, who has had my purse as if the strings were thine, shouldst know of this.
Lad, you will not hear me, if ever I did dream of such a matter abhor me.
Thou tollst me, thou didst hold him in thy hate.
Despise me if I do not. Three great ones of the city, in personal suit, to make me his lieutenant, off cap to him. And by the faith of man, I know my price, am worth no worse a place. But he, as loving his own pride and purposes, evades them with a bombast circumstance horribly stuffed with epithets of war. And in conclusion, none suits my mediators. For, certes, says he, I have already chosen my officer. And what was he? Forsooth, a great arithmetician, one Michael Cassio, a Florentine, a fellow almost damned in a fair wife, that never set a squadron in the field, nor the division of a battle knows more than a spinster. And as the bookish theoric, wherein the togged consuls can propose as masterly as he, mere prattle without practice is all his soldiership. But he, sir, had the election. And I, of whom his eyes had seen the proof, at Rhodes, at Cyprus, and on other grounds, Christian and heathen, must be lead and calmed by debitor and creditor. This counter-caster, he, in good time must his lieutenant be, and I. God bless the mark, his moorship's ancient.
By heaven, I rather would have been his hangman.
Aye, there's no remedy. It is the curse of service. Preferment goes by letter and affection, not by the old gradation where each second stood heir to the first. Now, sir, be judge yourself whether I in any just term am a fine to love the moor.
I would not follow him then.
Oh, sir, content you. I follow him to serve my turn upon him. We cannot all be masters, nor all masters cannot be truly followed. You shall mark many a duteous and knee-crooking knave that, doting on his own obsequious bondage, wears out his time much like his master's ass for naught but provender. And when he's old, cashiered, whip me such honest knaves. Others there are who, trimmed in forms and visages of duty, keep yet their hearts attending on themselves, and throwing but shows of service on their lords, do well thrive by them. And when they have lined their coats, do themselves homage. These fellows have some soul, and such a one do I profess myself. For, sir, it is as sure as you are Roderigo, were I the Moor, I would not be Iago. And following him, I follow but myself. Heaven is my judge. Not I for love and duty, but seeming so for my peculiar end. For when my outward action doth demonstrate the native act and figure of my heart in compliment extern, 'tis not long after, but I will wear my heart upon my sleeve for doors to peck at. I am not what I am.
What a full fortune does the thick lips owe if he can carry it thus.
Call up her father, rouse him, make after him, poison his delight. Proclaim him in the street, incense her kinsman, and though he in a fertile climate dwell, plague him with flies. Though that his joy be joy, yet throw such chances of vexation on't as it may lose some colour.
Here is her father's house. I'll call aloud.
Do, with like timorous accent and dire yell as when by night and negligence the fire is spied in populous cities.
What ho, Brabantio!
Oh.
Signor Brabantio, ho!
Awake! What, oh, Brabantio? Thieves, thieves! Look to your house, your daughter, and your bags! Thieves, thieves!
What is the reason of this terrible summons? What's the matter there?
Signor, is all your family within?
Are your doors locked?
Why? Wherefore ask you this?
Zoon, sir, you're robbed! For shame, put on your gown, your heart is burst, you've lost half your soul, even now, now, very now! An old black ram is topping your white ewe. Arise! Arise! Awake the sorting citizens with the bell! Or as the devil will make a grandsire of you. Arise, I say!
What? Have you lost your wits?
Most reverend signor, do you know my voice?
Not I. What are you?
My name is Roderigo.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.